Folks, I'm back. Sometimes life gets in the way of life. But today I get to do something I want to do, which is get this crazy Godin guitar going. I've had this switch in a bin over there for months, you know. I leveled all the frets, and I crowned them, and I never polished them. So we'll do that today, and put this sucker back together and see what kind of noises it makes. Yeah, so I'm just going to do the final polish on these guys. That's over with. So I want to just take a moment and thank everybody for the overwhelming response in regard to getting a sticker and entering my prize surprise giveaway, the purple Barney caster, right? And it looks really good. The amount of support you guys have shown, I haven't done a final tabulation yet, but I will. So February 1st, folks, I will pick a name out of the many that contributed. So you still got time. The PayPal thing is below me. Below me! Yeah, okay. Oh, and you may ask, what am I using to polish the frets? That go. It's nice stuff. Why am I doing it by hand? Well, because you see every time you use it, it ends up on a rag. So, you know, I've seen some guys try and get tricky and use that little, where is it? I have one. I use this for something different altogether than polishing things. I use it to hold strings up off of frets when I'm doing things. But anyway, guys, you know, so if you use that little wheel, well, the first time you use it, it gets all clogged up with that. So at that point, I don't know. I know they seem to come out shiny. So, whoa, look at that. Let's figure out this electronic debacle. And I gotta find the parts. It's been a part for so long I can't even remember where I put the shit. What the hell is that was on there? String trees? Why did they get taken off? Did I do that? Stay tuned and find out. As you can see, it's had many modifications, but this little switch, as I've come to figure out, this DiMarzio here is a stacked humbucker, and when you flip that switch, it puts it into a true single coil mode. But you know, you open something like this up, you're it. So first thing I always do, take a big picture, because if a wire falls off while I'm trying to fix what's actually broken, well, I'm it. Well, that's a new one. You put the locking tooth washer on the opposite side of the switch. Well, now I just want to punch somebody in the head. He somehow managed to put a nut on the back side too. And that thing is just jammed in there. What the hell happened here? Yeah, so what dude did is he basically used the switch as a tap and threaded the pick guard. So I'm not doing that. The hell are you thinking, dude? Right now, I'm looking for
The magical green mirror, which I just was looking at the other day. Maybe I'll pop. Oh, there it is. Pop right out.
And we'll just expand this a little bit so that the freaking switch actually fits through the hole. There, now we're okay. Well, everything works. It's tough to really tell if that does any sort of a tone shift without strings on it, obviously. The pickup doesn't shut off. I don't quite get what it's at, but we've got this multi-position thing, which I believe the whole idea is to give you many combinations. I think in the case there is a feeble explanation and diagram as to what the hell this is supposed to do. But most importantly, we're going to put it back together and make it play. Hey, check it out. It's a guitar again. But this is going to be a little challenging. Mainly because, I'll back up here a bit. The way they routed this so that the trim floats, right? Well, what we want to do is we want to get that so it's going to stay exactly where it's going to be when I release the springs to balance the poor guy. But I'm going to have to invent something that I can put in there to keep that distance correct, right? So I'm wondering, maybe I'll get real fancy here. I think I got something. So I think I'm sort of bending the rules of what this was invented for. This is a trem stopper, right? So what it allows you to do is set this, you mount this into the cavity, a couple of holes, and it'll let me adjust that set screw so I can push this so it's nice and level for the whole setup. And I'll crank the springs in, but this will keep that level. That's the idea, one of the ideas. Trem stopper, neck check guitars. So I'm just going to install that. What the hell? And that's what I'm going to do, because that's the kind of guy I am. So now what that little guy's going to let me do once I get it set up and balanced is that any time if I really don't want it to float anymore and I just want it to go forward, you can just set that hex screw, machine screw, and lock it off and it'll stay there. But right now what it's doing is it's keeping it nice and level for me, and I've got the springs all cranked in, so I'll release it and get it to work properly front ways. Now we can either keep that or spin it out of the way and make it float. Cool stuff, huh? And I'd also say that, just, you know, my inventive mind tells me that if I owned a guitar with a Floyd, this would be a great add-on just for setup ease of use. You know, you can lock it, do all your stuff, spin that away and get it to balance, right? After you spin that away, after you get it to balance in the forward direction, and obviously it's going to float the opposite direction once you get that. Pretty cool. Well, I'm thinking. Hey, well. So now I can go through just the normal setup nonsense, and then I'll release the spring tension in the back just so it starts to creep that way, and then for the floating aspect of it, all I have to do is wind that machine screw out of the bracket in the back here, right? Back that guy off and it'll float. And if you wanted to lock it off and didn't want it to float, you have that option. So that's what those are about. But like I said, from a setup standpoint, that really helped a lot, because I would have been sort of rat screwed here to try to make that sit where it needs to sit. Yeah, so we'll just get down to some good old neck relief. And survey says it's a little too straight. So hopefully Mr. Truss Rod down there will release. I'm sure when I took it all apart that I made sure I left it in a straight condition. That's not the right guy. First we'll find the right wrench, then we'll get the string out of the way. Yeah, that should be good. It moved. I'm gonna just a little bit more. A little bit more. There we go. And I'm not sure, this might even have a two-way truss rod in it. We'd have to check with the boys and girls at Godin. Godin. Be right back. Survey says... I can live with that. I can roll with that. It's probably still needs to be loosened up a little bit though. Let's do that. Yeah, I quit that adjustment. Okay, string height. It's a Fender scale. So we'll use Fender Speculations. It's time to sing the old intonation song. You all know it well. String height is lovely. This I might actually be okay. Slightly sharpish there. Very sharpish there. Super close with the balance of the trem. It's not going to take much until it just starts to float its way off of that trem blocker that I've got in the back. Alright. Bit more, I think. Is it still touching? Is it still touching? Can I see? Just a barely. Pack that off just another whisker. Yeah, that's it, baby. That's nice. So now it's synchronous. And obviously if I release that guy, it'll become floating. There's a wicked tone coming out of this thing. It's trying this. It's like... crazy, the tone shifting. And I really don't think this switch does anything. I can't hear anything that changes. That's sweet. Okay, that's it. Shout out to Dave Parker at Neck Check. He fabric cobbles these things together. And I'm glad I remembered that he sent me that, because this is a perfect opportunity to stick one of those things in there. I like it. Let's make it float. And anyway, yeah, I will make it float eventually. I'm not going to get into that right now. I got to go. Things are cooking, if you know what I mean. But back to the old Barney caster. Here it is, folks. Awaiting its new owner. There's still time to get a sticker and help support the channel and help support the War Amps charity. And it's going to be a fantastic donation. I can tell you that already. Two more days. February 1st, I will pull the trigger. Cheers, folks. Love you all. Patrons, subscribers, Facebook buddies. See you soon.